Hey guys, and welcome to another video. In this video, I want to show you a new build that I've been suggested by a friend of mine, known as the Enterprise. Or mainly it's either more of a concept even, which is an anvil-powered mob, spawner and crusher. Mainly I designed this to, you know, just for fun. I didn't really think anyone would actually try to build this in a survivor world or anything, because most of the things in this build are actually cheated. But I was surprised that it is actually functional in one way or another. So yeah, let's actually show you guys what it does. So, first of all, as you can see, this is the main contraption, being put in action. So, as you can see right here, we got a basic cursed earth spawner from the mod Extra Utilities, basically spawning monsters in a rapid rate, and I got myself a dynamism plate with a reinforced watering can in there to increase the tick rate, so it increases the amount of mobs that are being spawned right here. Behind that, I got myself a set of fans. I believe they are from Open Blocks or also Extra Utilities. I'm not quite sure. But they are pushing the mobs away from the cursed earth into the conveyors right here. And the conveyors is putting them into this pretty much loader area. So that is actually already pretty cool, just so you're able to massively stock the amount of monsters in an area. So that's pretty cool, because normally the amount would be limited by that. So something like this would be a fairly simple solution. Then up here, like I said, this is really more of a, you know, concept idea. So this is mostly based around creative stuff. So pretty much right here, I got myself a creative strongbox with some very damaged anvils in them. Being automatically pumped into these transvector interfaces, being bound to the block placers underneath them. These are Project Red block placers, so just if you guys were wondering. Because pretty much I needed one side of each block to be used for inputting, and one to be used for actually receiving a redstone signal. So this was pretty much the only rather simple way I could think of to do it in this fashion, just to use a bunch of these transvector interfaces being linked to that. So yeah, pretty cool. Hooked up to a wireless receiver, just so I can control it from down there. And then right here, I got pretty much the same idea, but then some block breakers, just to break the anvils that did not break on their own. And sometimes when they are really full, you will be able to see that this thing starts glitching out a bit. Then right here, we got a wireless receiver on another frequency, just so I can control these separately. Then right here, I got myself a chest with an advanced item collector on it, set to collect all the items in a nearby area, including the mob drops from there. Then they are being pumped into this barrel system, and that is pretty much the main idea of this farm. So, behind here, I got myself two controls, an anvil launcher and an anvil breaker, hooked up to a nut gate, a timer, and a repeater, then hooked up to a wireless transmitter to be one for that one and one for down. So, let's just turn them both on and see what it does. This one, I believe I set it on a 20-second clock, just because anvils are quite loud and, yeah, just... Nah, you don't want to this thing to tick like once every 2 seconds or something, because that would be crazy and annoying for you guys. So if you can see in a second, the anvils will drop, all the mobs will be killed, the loot will be sent into the chest right here, and then it will be sorted accordingly. Pretty cool. I mean, I don't believe the drops are like a decent amount of drops you will be getting from this, nor is this any way efficient, or is this, you know, meant to be used in a normal Minecraft world. But, you know, just try it stuff out. Like, I never really thought that, you know, something like this would be even possible. Because I, you know, never really messed around with dropping of anvils before. So yeah, pretty cool. So that's pretty much the main idea of this video. As you could also see, any remaining anvils will be broken. Like, as you can see right here, I got myself 5 anvils remaining. That's just sometimes broken. Then it breaks them all again, and some very rarely it will leave one more, but then the next round it will most likely catch them all, and it should be all good to go again. So, yeah, pretty cool. So, like I said, this is pretty much the main idea of this video. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, feel free to hit that like button down below, and of course hit that subscribe button to be up to date with every time I upload more videos and content just for you guys. Be sure to comment down below if you have any other feedback or suggestions, because this series or this channel is only awesome because of you guys. So like always, thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.